Hi, welcome back to Skyward Sword. So the last video was so far away, I think I thought I meant this one closer. You can actually see what's going on. Hey, Link. I was hoping I'd find you here. Hang on. I heard you gone searching for your bird around the waterfall, so I thought I'd fly around and help you look. How's your search going? Any sign of your loftling? Oh, no. Let's not lose hope yet. There's a place up ahead that Bruce and his gang are always hanging around. Maybe we'll find something there. Huh? Who's that? He's calling for me. Oh, sorry, Link. I got distracted for a moment. Let's go. And she falls right behind us. Let me give you Zelda. Where's my whistle? Look, there he is. Don't doubt about it. That's your lost wing, Link. Okay, first things first. Let's open the barrels. It's crazy when you're not near it. Okay, just follow the rope. Get the boards off. And how they are. No. You can't play online against somebody in this game. Yes. That's what mom thought. This is what gamers. I do. I like doing it. You should hurry, Link. Now that your ball playing is free, you should fly to the ceremony. Before you go, I have to ask you something. I heard this voice a few moments ago. Did you hear it too? It's been happening a lot lately. It's the strangest feeling, almost like someone is calling out to me. Have you ever wondered what's beneath the clouds? Some say that it's an empty, barren place, or even that there's nothing at all down below. But I just had this feeling that they're wrong. Some of Father's old texts talk about a place called the surface. The old tales describe a whole world under there, far more vast than Skyloft. The thing is, no one's ever been down there to see it, and our loft wings won't fly through the cloud barrier. But I can't help imagining the wild things that might be waiting below. Someday, I want to see it for myself. Oh, sorry, Link. We don't have time to talk. Let's get going. Look, your bird's waiting for you. Just leap off the edge and press the down button. Don't worry about falling. Your bird will catch you for sure this time. Nod. Basically a tutorial. should have done it up to here last time. Oh, I forgot to start reading. Whatever. I missed it already, so... Here's Bruce. No. Well, well. If it isn't, like... Right around the plaza as you found that dumb bird of yours. Well, that's just great, because you and your dumb bird can't tell time. All the previous warm-ups, me and the guys, they were for nothing. Now I'm all stiff. We've been waiting forever for the race to start, and they delayed it for you. I don't get it. The big flake gets special treatment. You're almost a man, and yet you still can't seem to go anywhere without Zelda. Yeah. I bet you can't even decide what to have for lunch on your own, huh? And don't think we haven't noticed the smug look on. Looks. Ooh, Zelda and I are best friends. We go everywhere together. Ugh. I think you're pretty suave, don't you? Well, don't you? Bruce has been going on forever about how he's going to be the one to be with Zelda. He's really got his pompadour, I guess, in a ruffle about her. I hate to break it to you, today's the day I bust up this adorable little fantasy land you're living in. Zelda's playing the role of the goddess at today's ceremony, and I'm gonna be the one to claim that sailcloth. When I heard she made it herself, man, no way was I gonna let some scrawny clown snatch that prize from me. Oh yes, that sailcloth, Zelda's sailcloth, will be mine. Duh ho ho. Oh man, I bet she was thinking about me when she was stitching it. Yep, I can see it now. First, I win the big race. Then Zelda and I finish the ceremony together on the statue, just the two of us. It'll be our special moment alone. Nobody's stopping me and Zelda from having our moment. Oh, it's so real. I can see it. Oh yeah. Bruce, psst, Bruce, behind you. Right behind you. What? Can't you two see I'm in the middle of... Duh. Can't you explain just what you meant by our special moment alone? Nothing big, really. Just... Link, yeah, I was just telling my buddy here how glad I was he found that red butterfish. Boy, am I looking forward to a fair race. Anyhow, later, Zelda, look for me during the race. I'll be the one pulling off all the dangerous moves. Hey, Bruce, wait up! I still have the sword. Did you hear that, guy? A fair race. Yeah, the chances of that happening are just about less than zero. Oh my god, my head's itchy. Either way, don't let those fools get you down, Link. Just get out there and fly the best you can. Hang on, I forgot my glasses. I'll make it first when I get my that took so long, I was talking to my sister. Okay. I know you've got these guys beat, and deep down, I think you do too. I don't know, yeah, us alone. Let's go, yeah. That's the spirit, Link. Trust me, you can win this. The wing ceremony will... The wing ceremony will now begin. Participating students, please assemble. Looks like it's race time. Good luck, Link. Woo! That's cool. I want to do that. Your attention, please. At last, we are ready to begin the wing ceremony. I was beginning to worry that we'd have to proceed without Link, but luckily that is no longer a concern. I'm glad you could all make it. Before we start, I'll explain the rules for today's competition. I have attached a small statuette to this bird, who I will then release to the skies. On my signal, press A to dash and dive off the... and dive off the ledge. Once you are in the air, mount your Loflin. Remember to call your bird promptly with the down button once you dive off the ledge. Whoever catches the bird and claims the statuette with A will be this year's champion. With dash. I should say dash. Those are the rules. Simple enough, I think. But do you need to hear them again? Excellent. As you well know, today's champion will graduate to the next class, bringing him one step closer to knighthood. He will also receive a gift from the young woman chosen to play the role of the goddess in this year's ritual. Today is a special day for many reasons, but it is also the 25th anniversary of our fine institution. To celebrate the occasion, today's champion shall also receive his gift high atop the statue of the goddess. I hear the young woman performing the role of the goddess this year has crafted the gift herself. And as you all well know, the role of the goddess this year will be performed by the lovely Zelda. Let's see your finest flying out there. Show me just how hard you've been practicing. Also, I want to see good, clean flying. Anyone caught interfering with other riders will answer to me. That goes double for you. Alright, gentlemen, line up. At my command, the competition will begin. Woo! Go! I thought you would automatically jump off. I forgot. Can't do well with that. Come on. Ow! Where'd the bird go? Dang it. Stupid Gross. Come on. Hey, don't you know this is my day to get all the glory? Egg on your face. Ow. Yes. Got it. You got the bird statuette. It proves your victory today. Wait till Zelda sees this. Don't worry, I'm fine. Great flying, Link. Congratulations. Now we better get on with the ceremony. Aw, that's cute. Thanks. Hand me that bird statuette you grabbed in the race. I must offer it to the goddess. I want to lay it back up here, God. You can't after this. The song of the goddess, the ballad of the goddess. Aww. Great goddess, guiding light and protector of our people, grant us your blessing and mercy as I act in your stead during this ceremony. Valiant youth who grasp victory at the celebration of the bird folk in accordance with the old ways, I now bestow the blessing of the goddess upon you. Blessing of the goddess drift down. The blessings of the goddess drift down from the heavens aloft a sail, which I now pass on to you. You got the sailcloth. We got the thing. I love Chuggy Conroy. Now you can jump from any height without fear of a painful landing. It smells nice too. Link, quit goofing. This is supposed to be a sacred ritual, remember? You know, they say that the goddess gave the sailcloth to her chosen hero long ago. Of course, the one you're holding isn't the same one. I've been working hard to finish making this sailcloth in time to give it to today's champion. I'm really glad I got to give it to you, Link. Make sure you take good care of it, okay? Nod. Thanks for making it up here to do this with me today, like you promised, Link. Aww. Now, we really should finish up this ritual. You do know what happened at the end, right? Uh-oh. And just what are you thinking? Don't be silly. This is your big moment. Link, I was thinking, uh-oh, because you'll see. Not this. Not what you're thinking. You have to jump off the statue. Look down. See that big round design on the courtyard below? The first time I tried this, I failed. I was like, what the heck? Finish the ceremony, you need to drop right into the center of it. Leap off the edge here. Right before you hit the ground, press B to open up your sailcloth. Just how brave are you? If you were really fearless, you'd wait until the last second to use your sailcloth. So, ready to jump? Push! Now that I know how to do this, last second. That was perfect. You're amazing, Link. Aww. You know, Link, seeing as how you went today, and with the weather being so nice, you think maybe you'd like to, go flying around the clouds together? Aww, I love this. It's so sweet. Till she falls. Spoiler alert. Link! Say it was amazing watching you win the race and performing the witch ritual together. I'll always remember this. It really was wonderful. No, Link. There's something I've been meaning to talk to you about. What is that? I am waiting for you. The time has come for you to awaken. You are vital to a mission of great importance. Link. Ah, you're awake. When your loved one carried you back, you were limp and unconscious. I feared the worst. Fortunately, you don't appear to have any serious injuries. For that much, we can be grateful.
Aww.
Well, Link, where is Zelda? She was with you, was she not? What's happened to my daughter? A tornado, you say? That was no ordinary storm. You must not push yourself. You're still recovering. Tell me, when you saw Zelda today, did anything about her seem off? See, she was talking about the surface then. And you've been having dreams about a great mission. How interesting.
Ooh. My back is killing me.
I'm sorry, I was lost in thought there for a moment. It's all very strange, but I doubt there's much of a connection between these things. I'm concerned for Zelda, but so long as she's with her loftmate, I'm sure she'll be fine. Either way, daybreak has yet to arrive. It would be very difficult to spot one girl and her bird in the dark of night. It would also be very dangerous. His shoulder is killing me. Rest now, Link. Zelda's going to be fine. She's out there alive. I know it. I forgot how many hearts you start out with. It kind of it sounds like she's saying Malink, like Master Link, for sure. Sort of. There she is! The girl from our dream. Okay, that sounds really weird. Can't run too fast in it. Building. I still have the turning sword. Aww, cute, you think? Then it turns around. You can't really hurt it, you just scare it. Well, but you hurt it in doing so. But still, it won't hit you in the morning. That was quick. That's all really cute when you pick it up. Can't get me. Mr. Angry Eyes. Peace. I forgot the sword does nothing against them. You got a jelly bob. And that's the first thing I collect, of course. You can find amber relics everywhere, basically. I was like waiting for a dance motion. Okay, start off with 6 hearts. Which is actually a good thing for Zelda games, because, you know, you usually start off with like 3. Oh, that's why they only replenish 6 hearts. The fairies, and when you die. And there is the sword. It's not the master sword yet. It's the Skyward sword right now. Just call by that. The one chosen by my creator, I have been waiting for you. You will play a role in a great destiny. According to your social customs, I should provide you with my personal designation. Phi is the name I was given. Phi or Phi. Yeah, Phi Phi Fo Fo. I was created for a single purpose, long before the recorded memory of your people. I must aid you in fulfilling the great destiny that is your burden to carry. Come, Link, you must take up this sword as the one chosen by my creator. It is your destiny.
I want on there. Can I get my face on there?
The strange dreams troubling your sleep, a sudden appearance, uncertainty surrounding the fate of one you hold dear. Under the circumstances, it is only logical that you would exhibit some apprehension. God, to use his big words. To minimize your uncertainty, allow me to share some information. My projections indicate that this information has a high probability of altering your current emotional state. The one you seek, honorable, Honorable Zelda is still alive. And this spirit maiden, the one you call Zelda, is another chosen one fated to be part of the same great mission. Therefore, should you wish to meet with your friend, I highly recommend you take up this sword before you set out to search for her. There should be an and there. Does that information invigorate you? Are you ready to accept this sword? It seems that further persuasive measures will not be required. In the name of my creator, draw the sword and raise it skyward. Let's make it all dramatic. I'm just joking. Yeah, raise it, Skyward. It'll go faster later on once you get it set up. You got the goddess sword. Oh, that's what it's called. Okay. This mysterious sword is bathed in divine light. You'll start to load the Skyward Strike faster later on. Recognition complete. Master. Link. My master. Link. Scared me too. I forgot he comes in here. I've had my suspicions, but until now I wasn't sure. Yet here we are in the Chamber of the Sword, the very place where it was foretold the youth of legend would one day appear. It is said that this place was left to our people by the goddess herself. The very knowledge of this room's existence is a secret passed down to a select few in each generation, along with a handful of words. You got that right. When the light of the goddess's sword shines bright, the great apocalypse will wake from its long slumber. Do not fear, for it is then that a youth guided by my hand shall reveal himself in a place most sacred. It started days ago. The sword that I've kept secret all these years began to give off a faint, otherworldly light. At first, I was sure I was seeing things here alone with the sword. There was simply no other explanation. I never dreamed the prophecy of legend would come to pass in my lifetime. The words I have sworn to keep secret are coming true before my very eyes. The youth will be guided by one born of the blade, one who is also youthful in likeness, yet wise with knowledge immeasurable. Ah, yes, the oral tradition. One of the least reliable methods of information retention and transmission. It appears that critical sections of the passage have been lost over the generations. The youth who draws forth the guiding sword shall be known as the goddess's chosen hero, and it is he who possesses an unbreakable spirit. He shall be burdened with the task of abolishing the shadow of apocalypse from the land. Such is his destiny. With the spirit of the blade at his side, he shall soar over the clouds and plummet below, and united with the spirit maiden, shall bring forth a piercing light that resurrects the land. Some of Father's old texts talk about a place called the surface. The old tales describe a whole world below, far more vast than Skyloft. Master, you must embark on a great journey beneath the clouds to the vast realm of the surface. It is only through this journey that you can fulfill the mission set before you by my creator, the goddess. It is also the only method available for you to reunite with the spirit maiden, Honorable Zelda. This is no easy task, Link. The world below is a forsaken place, and to reach it, you must pierce the cloud barrier below. In living memory, no one has ever done this. Ready! We got the thing! This tablet will illuminate a path through the clouds to the land below. Take it and place it within the altar behind me. We got the Emerald Tablet. We got the Emerald Tablet. The weathered surface of this heavy stone tablet feels very old. Master, the first thing you must do is hit the crest sitting in this room with a Skyward strike. These blasts are formed of pure energy that charges within your blade when you lift it skyward. Once you have charged your blade, face the crest and swing your sword to send out a powerful Skyward strike. I might want to get closer. You know, up here. Ah, pretty music. Master Link, it is done. Until now, a cloud barrier created by the goddess has separated the world you know from the one below. The tablet you placed in the altar has opened a small rift in the barrier. You can use it to travel through the clouds to the realm below. I have recognized you as my master, and so it is my duty to follow you wherever you may go. I reside within your sword and will accompany you in your travels. Press the down button to summon me whenever you require my assistance. So basically, the down button is just like a summoning button throughout this whole game. Link, listen a moment. The nature of the great apocalypse mentioned in the old text is a complete mystery to me. But whatever it turns out to be, it seems that both you and Zelda have big roles to play in the destiny of this land. Just think, if what this fee says is true, Zelda is alive. Alive and no doubt coming to terms with whatever it is the goddess has in store for her. Should you heed the call of destiny, I don't know what dangers you may have to face, Link. Especially down there. But if you desire to brave the unknown, please find my daughter and bring her back to me. What we've seen here today defies explanation, but it is only the start of your journey. Please see it through and prove the legend's true. So much. Okay. No way. Okay. You do your people proud, Link. Dawn is drawing near. It has been a long night for the both of us, hasn't it? You have a great journey before you, Link, and those clothes, they don't look up to the task. I like this. I like this better than the regular thing. The uniform you were to receive for winning the race should be ready by now. A sturdy uniform like that will prove much more suitable for a long journey. You better change before you go. Nod. I like these clothes. There's a glitch in, well, not really a glitch. Someone found out how to keep his regular clothes in, Wind Waker. forgot who. I forgot their username and stuff. But they did. After this, I'll end the little video here. That green uniform is what our knights will be wearing this year. To be honest, I have had doubts about the color. But oddly enough, seeing you wear this uniform, I can't imagine a more fitting color for you. It's as though you were born to wear it. I like how he looks in this one. Take care on your journey, and be sure to stop by some of the shops at the bazaar here in town to equip yourself properly for the travels ahead. I will return to my quarters and see if I can glean more useful information from the ancient texts. You are always welcome to stop by if you have any questions. You and Zelda shall be in my prayers. May the goddess watch over you and guide both of you. Guide you both. Either way, it's the same thing. Okay. That'll be the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope my dad didn't like